It's a good idea, but it'll never work.
Well, I'm tapped out. Remake of The Hunger Games is my last good idea. I've got nothing left.
Me neither.
The problem is, how do you properly capture all of the emotions of articling in a 5-minute video? I mean, there's the pain, the highs, the lows, the other lows, the friendships, the pain, the paranoia.
And the pain.
And the pain!
He's right. There's just too much to boil it all down.
I don't know. I think my articling year can be summed up pretty easily.
All right, picture this.
Hi, Stacy. Slightly good news. Some of the work has already been done for us. Please see the attached. 5 minutes later. Hi, Stacy. Terrible news. I'll swing by to discuss. Thanks.
1:25 a.m. Thank you for the snotter. You should get some sleep now, but please come in at 8 a.m. Thank you.
Thanks, but that doesn't answer my question. The issue is more nuanced. This one just says, good grief.
And then 2 days later I got, thanks, I'll take it from here.
Well shit, man. Look at the articling student showing who's boss.
I wrote a really long memo recently, and the response I received was, thanks, Andrew.
Hi, blank. It's blank. We've managed to get access to the files that you received from our company. Every single file we are now looking at is empty. Is it possible that the student, when she was going through everything, had removed all of the files from there? I'm not saying that she for sure did, but I am asking the question. Give me a call back when you know where that's at. Thanks.
You know, that could actually work. But would anyone believe people actually said those things?
They'll believe it if they worked with us.
Fair point.
I like that idea, but I don't think it really captures the deep-seated paranoia that, for me, really defined articling.
True. I would comb through completely normal emails looking for some hidden meaning.
Thank you. ... What does it mean?
Exactly. Okay, here's how I would sum up articling.
We have a real X-file on our hands here. I keep getting these messages. They mean something. They have to mean something.
Or they mean nothing at all. And you want to believe there's something out there so badly that you're searching for meaning where there is none.
Not this time, Scully. This time, it's real. And I know just the people who can help us crack the code.
Are you sure about this, Mulder? I've heard these articling students are kind of out there.
That's just what they want you to think.
Oh, hi, you must be the agency I called, so come on in.
Hi, yes, I'm Agent Mulder, and this is Agent Scully. Are you busy?
With this? No. This is just Doc. Here you got a sign. Can we see it? Oh my god, this is incredible. Come take a look.
Whoa.
I've never seen anything like that.
It's amazing.
You know, in a strange way, it's kind of beautiful.
So, do you know what it means?
Not even a little. But I think I know who could help.
We call upon the spirits of the past. Here in this boardroom, we conference call with the spirits of former articling students who have moved into the great unknown and who bear the wisdom of many rotations.
By the partners emeritus, we call upon you spirits. Speak to us and reveal to us the mysteries of this message.
Mulder, this is insane. I'm getting out of here.
Wait, wait. I hear something. A spirit approaches.
Was someone calling me? I was really drawn to this room. Does someone have snacks? Ah, thanks.
Do you know what this means?
No idea. Have you asked Carrie?
Sorry, I hate to tell you, but this means nothing. Sometimes thank you just means thank you.
I understand.
It could mean anything, Scully, anything. We've tried everything and we're no closer to the truth.
Well, there is one person we could ask.
Welcome, agents. Sit down. Do you have the message?
Yes. Can you tell what this means?
What group is this from?
It was from corporate.
I see. Well, I'm afraid they're not interested. Have you thought about litigation?
That's what that means?
Of course. It's all right there. Clear. Plain as day.
That's great news. Thank you. Thank you. Come on, Scully. We got a lot of work to do. We have to express interest in a whole new group. We gotta talk to our mentors.
It's me, Navana.
You guys are so dramatic. It wasn't all painful. Don't you remember the early days of articling when we were all fresh-faced and happy? Almost paradise. We're knocking on heaven's door. Almost paradise. How could we ask for more? I swear that I can see forever in your eyes. Paradise.
Maybe it's just because I've never watched Bachelor in Paradise, but I don't ever remember feeling like that.
Well, that's just because you and litigation were the first couple on the island and you never looked back.
I don't know what that means.
I think what we're getting at here is that articling has been bittersweet. And it's bittersweet that it's ending, too. Maybe we should try to do something that reflects that feeling.
I know just the thing.
Stacey, can I get some thank you note music, please? Thank you, Delivery Law, for expanding my horizons beyond the city of Toronto to the lovely towns of Grimsby, Tiny Township, and Brantford.
Thank you, beautiful weather, for taunting me from my office window, when I have a window, knowing full well I will never experience you.
Thank you, Pods, for helping me realize that I'm one quarter of the student that I thought I was.
Thank you, Mark. Just thank you.
Thank you to Docketing for telling me exactly how much time it took to not find that case.
Thank you, Fishbowls, for teaching me the exact right moment to make eye contact with someone walking down the hall.
finally, thank you to Carrie, Kat, Dan, the entire student committee, Nancy, Lisa, and all of our mentors for helping us through our article year. We couldn't have done it without you, and we want you to know that we appreciate everything you do for us.
Thank you!
Honestly, this all sounds like way too much work.
Yeah. You know, I bet if we put this off long enough, we could eventually just pass it off to the summer students.
I love it.
It's beautiful.
The man's a genius. Lunch?
Lunch!